In his 13th October 2022 letter to Speaker of Parliament Anita Among, President Museveni questioned why Parliament deviated from 30% government's contribution to savers that was cleared by the Minister of Finance with a certificate of a financial implication, and why MPs increased government contribution to 40% without government approval. Parliament passed into law the Parliamentary Pensions Amendment Bill 2022 on 8th September 2022 and approved a proposal to have the contribution of government to MPs' pension savings increased from 30% to 40%, while the savers' contribution from 15% to 20%. The President's refusal to assent to the bill has annoyed MPs. Legislators have vowed to return the bill to the president without changing a word, claiming the increment is justifiable.
So you can't say provide for the judiciary, provide for the executive, but you not provide for the members of parliament or the or this arm of government. It is the three arms of government, and once you're legislating, you must talk about fairness and equality. And so for me, I'm really perturbed that the president wants comfort. That I say I am not comfortable. It's not about him. It's about the institutions of government, and they are independent, and he must respect them.
Calculate how much is 10% of increment on our pension. How much is it? It's around 160 billion. So this is when I say the president is not fair. And whether he likes it or he doesn't want, we are going to pass it. We are going to pass it. We are the people that appropriate. We are allowed to pass the bills even when he does not assent to them after a particular amount of time. And we are going to give the Ugandans reasons why we decided to increase pensions on our own.
The Parliament Pensions Bill was first tabled in July by Arinaitwe Rwakajara, the workers' MP, intended to ease access to the retirement benefits, repeal the requirement to a recommendation of the Uganda Medical Board in case a member or pensioner seeks to use a proportion of their benefits for medical treatment. But some lawmakers concur with the president that it was irregular for Parliament to pass a private member's bill that has huge financial implication on government.
Because you see, this is a private member's bill. And in a private member's bill, you are supposed to abide by the provisions of Article 93 of the Constitution. You do not bring a bill, a motion, that has an effect of having a charge on the consolidated fund. So that particular provision was uncalled for, and the president is right.
Now that we added 10% on 30%, it means it will come to 40%. I really feel the president look at it, that it may be too huge. It may put a lot of burden onto the government's coffer. That is why he decided that he cannot sign that.
Solomon Sirang, the Commissioner of Parliament, has disclosed that a reconsideration of this bill is priority in number one as soon as Parliament resumes.
Bills that the Prime Minister prioritized, there was a bill that was returned, the Parliamentary Pension Amendments Bill. We shall start with that one on Tuesday.
The bill also provided for the benefits of former speaker and deputy speakers that have served from 1980, a walk back from the earlier 2007 position that provided for the benefits to apply to these leaders who had served from 2007. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.